at the beginning of 2006, and it's called Un Paso en el Tiempo, Historia de Hospitalidad a la Vera del Camino del Apóstol. A passing time, or a step in time, history of hospitality on the Camino or Road of the Apostle Santiago. And there are two authors, myself, Antonio Regalado, and Beth Ann Lahoski. The idea of the book was to do something on hospitality, with hospitality along the Camino de Santiago, the pilgrimage road to San Jose of Compostela. Most books that are brought out now are personal experiences, which we are not interested in so much. Although we had a lot of personal experiences in the Camino. When there's a hospitality, without hospitality, there's no pilgrimage road. And that way we also talk about the pilgrimage road and hospitality today and hospitality yesterday. It's historical. We go from the present to the past. And we have picked a number of places in the Camino, beginning in Roncesvalles on the Spanish border, and then going all the way up to Galicia. And we have found individuals who practice hospitality today, and also have lived more or less in towns by the Camino and have inherited the tradition of helping pilgrims. It has a long bibliography and an index that allows a very detailed reading of the book, allows people to enter the book through themes and topics. The first two chapters are fiction. We use a technique of fiction, although they have accuracy. One is a pilgrim that returned more or less in the 12th, 13th century, not specified, in times of faith. He calls a pilgrimage in times of faith. Now they don't return walking, most of them don't. They go or they do a number of kilometers and then they return by public transportation. And the other one is a pilgrim that moves today, an average kind of individual who eventually discovers what is the Camino, because it's a Christian pilgrimage road. It originated with the birth of Europe in the 9th, 10th, and 11th century, and it has to do with the Christian origins of Europe. And well, it went into decadence in the 18th, 19th, 20th century, and it has been recovered now. So more or less, the book deals with pilgrimage almost as a metaphor for human existence. Man is a pilgrim in this world. And it has a lot of details, historical information, but it also deals with actuality, not history. A chapter on a small town in Navarra where the Camino goes through. It's called the Third Foot, Azqueta. And the town has about 80 people. It's a beautiful town with great views. And there's a man in his late 60s called Pablito. Pablito, and he enjoys doing bordones or pilgrim staffs, which he makes out of filbert trees, and he cuts off the branches and makes the walking staff and gives it to a lot of the pilgrims. So this chapter deals with him. He's always lived there and his family, and how his grandmother talked to him about pilgrims when there were not very many. There's been a renewal of the pilgrimage. And, well, the chapter deals with...